Hi, my name is John Phillipson Brown, and today I've come to El Rastro Market in Gijón. I think it should be a good place to find some nice objects for my classic still life painting.
Okay, so I've come back from the market with some things for the still life painting. Got some organic forms, good colours and shapes, lots of little details there. Contrast against the nice curves of these things, and good reflective surfaces. Should be a real challenge to paint those. So next thing is to set them up in a nice composition for our classic still life painting.
Bésame, que quiero sentir tus labios besándome otra vez, suavemente, bésame.
I find digital photography extremely useful as a tool for making decisions quickly about composition. The group of objects also need some space around them to look comfortable and not cramped. And we must remember here that if the finished painting is to be framed, then a little of the surface of the canvas will disappear under that frame, so take that into account as well. In composition, we're looking to achieve a pleasing, harmonious combination of shapes and colours. Contrasts of colour and tone and attractive shapes and lines make areas of visual interest in the painting. We need to imagine the canvas both as a flat surface and as a window into an illusionistic three-dimensional space that we're hoping to create on that surface. Creating a tension between these two ways of seeing has been an important preoccupation of painting for many centuries. Also, we must consider both the positive shapes of the object and the shapes of the negative spaces left between the objects. These are equally important. The composition should catch the viewer's eye and then lead it around the painting, visiting each area of interest in turn. I try out lots of combinations of objects, lots of possibilities, moving things around until I begin to get an idea of what I want. I like to think in terms of contrasts. Contrasts of colour, tone, light shapes against dark, and organic forms contrasting with sharper architectural shapes. I look at how each object relates to the next, taking special care with lines that lead the viewer's eyes, moving their attention onto the next part of the composition. Today, I'm using a picture frame with a grid of strings tied across it. This is helping me to visualize the composition in the proportions of the canvas, and it'll also be a great help when it comes to making a preparatory drawing. I'll do that in the next episode.